Good evening, everyone. Welcome back to our live show, Unanswered Questions. Viewers, today we have our guest, Mr. Akash sir. Just a brief introduction about Akash sir. Akash sir is alumni of MANET and a mechanical engineer. Sir is a prominent and well-known speaker of philosophy. Sir has a good hold on Vedic scriptures like Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, etc. So we heartily welcome you, sir, on our show.
Thank you very much, Yashveer sir. Okay. Well, I'm not worthy of such introduction, but still you have said so. I think it will be okay only.
It's Your Highness. Sir, today we have question which is asking why is scientific knowledge like gravity not present in scriptures? This is very interesting question. Asking scientific knowledge like gravity not present in scriptures. So over to you, sir.
So, okay, thank you very much. So this question is really very interesting, that why scientific knowledge is not present in Vedic scriptures. So actually, this question is not correct in itself, but still we will discuss it later. So let us divide our discussion in two parts. So first of all, let us see what scriptures are all about. What is the primary purpose of scriptures? So now, see, every book has a purpose. Like different books are there and they deal with different subject matters. Like if physics book is there, it will deal with physics. If English grammar book is there, then it will deal with the subject matter of English grammar. So whatever knowledge you want, you should refer to that particular kind of book. Now, let us come to our scriptures. So let's take the example of Bhagavad Gita. So now let us see what Bhagavad Gita is all about. So in Bhagavad Gita, Arjun is bewildered and Arjun is asking question to Lord Krishna. Karpanya doso opat svavo prachami tvam dharma sammuda cheta. He is saying dharma sammuda cheta. Arjun is saying to Lord Krishna, oh Lord, I am very much confused about my duties, about my course of action. So what should be my right course of action? So Lord Krishna is answering that question of Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita. Of course, Arjuna is not asking in Bhagavad Gita about scientific discoveries and other things. So whatever question Arjuna has asked, Lord will answer that only. So similarly, we can see that there is another great Vedic scripture, Srimad Bhagavatam, one of the great Puranas. So in Srimad Bhagavatam also, the Parikshit Maharaj, the main protagonist of the Srimad Bhagavatam, he is on the verge of death. He will die in 7 days. So here, the Srimad Bhagavatam deals with the subject matter of how one should act or what one should do when one is on the verge of death. So clearly we can see that the primary purpose of scriptures is to tell about God. And primary purpose of scriptures is not about scientific discoveries. So what I'm trying to say is that these two things, scriptures and science, they are not contradictory, rather they are complementary. Like I will tell you one example. Suppose, I remember one thing, that Galileo once said that science tells you how the heavens move, whereas religion tells you how to go to heaven. This was said by Galileo, one of the famous scientists, we all know him. So the difference is clear. Science tells you that how the things are working, and religion or scriptures, religious scriptures tells you who is behind all those things. Like there are two things behind everything. There are two things. One is the material mechanism and another one is the intelligent designer. Like take for example a computer. In computer is working as per its own set mechanism, but there is an intelligent designer who has created this computer. So science is interested in how this mechanism is working, whereas religion and religious scriptures are interested that who is behind that creation. So similarly, scientists are interested in how this material nature is working, how the laws are working, whereas religious scriptures are interested more in that who has created all these things, who has created all these mechanisms, who is that intelligent designer. So the primary purpose of scriptures is that one should understand that they deal with a higher subject matter. They deal with how to raise your level of consciousness. This is their main goal. Whereas the main goal of scientific books is to tell how this universe or these laws are working. So are you able to get what I'm trying to say?
Ah, yes, sir. It's like bit clear.
So
like you said, every book has a purpose. So you can't find all thing in one book. So
yes.
What purpose it is written? So that content you will be able to find in that particular book.
Yes.
Yeah.
Please tell me. Another thing we can ask that, is there no scientific knowledge in Shastras? Of course, there is scientific knowledge in Shastras, but that is not the primary objective of Shastras. Scientific knowledge is there in Shastra. So many scientific things, I am going to detail it out, that what scientific knowledge is there in our scriptures. But again, I would like to emphasize that this scientific knowledge, which is being mentioned in our Shastras, that is not the primary purpose of our scriptures. Like I will tell you, there is something known as Sar Darshan. They are the six schools of Vedic philosophy. And one of them is known as Vaisheshik. And the founder of Vaisheshik is Maharshi Kalan. So he has given the party this Paramadu theory, that he has given that everything is made up of atoms. And these things are told so many years back when Vedas were compiled. So he has told that everything is made up of atoms. So see, this thing which Dalton told us, I think in 18th century, this thing was already told. Now again, we can see that as far as medicine is concerned, we have our Ayurveda, and the relevance of Ayurveda is still very prominent. So you can see that the thing which were mentioned in our Vedas, in as far as medicine is concerned, they are also very relevant. Now come to this mathematical discoveries, like in Sulbh Sutras, there is one thing known as Sulbh Sutras. This is part of our Vedic scriptures. So in that entire thing, how to make architecture, about Pythagoras theorem, about angles, triangles, all these things, they are mentioned. In fact, Indo-Arabic numerals, they are also mentioned. Rather, Arabic name got later on, it was invented in India only, that decimal system. And again, we can see that our scriptures told that there are 84 lakh species of animals and plants combined. And in that, it said that 12 lakh species belong to plants. I think number is 12 lakh only. It may get some different. So main point I am trying to emphasize here is that our scriptures already told that plants have life. Whereas as far as modern science is concerned, it was only in, I think, about 1920s, 1930s when, which is the scientist, I think C.V. Raman or Jagdish Chandra Bose, I think one of them, he proved that they have life, plants have life. Similarly, as far as Srimad Bhagavatam is concerned, Jagdish Chandra Bose.
Yes.
So even this Srimad Bhagavatam, you go in third canto and you will find there that entire process of how the baby develops in the womb, how everything goes there, what happens in different months, entire thing is mentioned there. And see, this thing very much conforms to the modern scientific explanation. So I am just trying to show you that so many scientific things are mentioned. So specifically, as you asked this question, that why scientific things like gravity is not mentioned in our scripture, so I would like to correct you. I told you in the beginning that there is some correction in this question. So actually, ISRO chief Madhavan Nair, one of the very prominent person, so he was telling sometime before, he was telling that our Vedas have knowledge of gravity, but that knowledge was in condensed form. There are shlokas in our Vedic scriptures. I am going to quote those shlokas also, which tells about the gravitational force, but they were in condensed form. So scientists were not able to take them out. But certainly our scriptures had the knowledge about gravitation. And actually one thing he mentioned, this ISRO chief, former ISRO chief, he mentioned that this actually our scriptures told that there is water on moon. He was telling, I am quoting him only. And then he said that it was our Chandrayaan recently in 2007, it was launched, and later on. So it was Chandrayaan, and that too, I think 13, 14 years before that, discovered that there is water on moon. So this thing was predicted already in our Shastras. Now, as far as gravity is concerned, let me quote some shlokas. Actually, I have written them. So let me read it out for you. In Rig Veda 8.12.28, 8 means canto, 8th canto, 12th chapter, 28 verse. It is written, all planets remain stable as they come closer to sun due to attraction. Their speed of coming closer increases proportionately. So this shloka, it is strikingly similar to the Kepler's law. And then again in Rig Veda, first canto, 164 chapter 13 verse, it is said that sun moves in its own orbit, which itself is moving earth and other bodies. Now sun is moving in its own orbit, which itself is moving earth and other bodies move around the sun. Now see, one important point is it is saying that sun moves in its own orbit. See, sun is also not very stable, because everything is revolving around this in the center of each galaxy there is one black hole. So sun, and also there are other planets, so they also exert gravitational force, so there is little movement of sun. But since its gravitational pull is very much high, so it remains nearly stable. And now it is saying that earth and other bodies move around sun due to force of attraction. So this force of attraction is what? This is gravitation only, because sun is heavier than them. So this is being written in our Rig Veda. Similarly, in Athar Veda, fourth canto, 11th chapter, first verse, it is said, sun has held the earth and other planets. In Rig Veda 1.84.15, it is written, the moving moon always receives a ray of light from sun. See, it is written here also that moon receives the light from sun. And this is confirmed by scientific facts also now. And Rig Veda 1.6.5, it is written that, oh God, you have created this sun. You possess infinite power. You are upholding the sun and other sphere and render them steadfast by your power of attraction. So see, the main point which I was focusing, that there is material mechanism and then there is intelligent designer. So here in this shloka, it is saying that, oh Lord, oh God, you have created this force of attraction. So science is interested in this force of attraction known as gravitation. Whereas Vedas, they are interested in the one who has created this force of attraction. So here they are offering obeisances to that God who has created this force of attraction. So I think that, and actually these are only some of the things. I can tell you even more things. And as far as reference for this is concerned, I can tell you that also there is one website known as agniveer.com. On Google, one can go and check that. I am not quoting all these things from my own mind. I have taken it down from Google only. Right? So actually thing is this, that this knowledge is also mentioned in our Vedic scriptures, but the primary purpose of Vedas is to help us to awaken our consciousness and help us to God realization. So
it's very interesting, sir. You like being an engineer, and you're like a prominent like Vedic scripture reader also, and how you manage everything, and it's like very nice. It's like awakening things that we are like got to hear now. It's also, sir, like as you said, that scientific knowledge is present in scriptures, according to you, or yes. Is there like any question that some scientific knowledge or something like that? Because I just want to ask that, according to you, scientific knowledge is there, but we need to search in that respective scripture or that respective book, Anna?
Because yes.
Every book doesn't have scientific knowledge, because
yes.
The purpose behind the writing of that book or purpose behind that scripture, you need to take that, then you need to go ahead. So just I need more clarity on this, that is there no science, is there all scientific knowledge available in the scriptures, or like it's according to the need it is mentioned?
See, it's like that whatever the primary purpose of scriptures, I told you, was God realization. It is related to God. But still there are so many scientific things which were mentioned in our scriptures, which our ancient sages thought that they would be needed for these people. So it is at their discretion, like whatever knowledge they have mentioned, scientific knowledge. So they have mentioned that. So we cannot say that what knowledge they have mentioned and why and which knowledge they have not mentioned. So of course, as I told you, like that story, you may know that Newton created one model of solar system. So one friend came. So that friend said that this mechanism is very good. This solar system mechanism which you have created, he created that. This is very good, that all planets are moving around this artificial solar system you have created. So Newton said that, yes, it is very good, but there is an intelligent creator behind this solar system. So I have created this artificial little solar system. So certainly there must be an intelligent designer who has created this entire solar system. So science is more interested in how things are moving, and religion is more interested in who is moving the things. So whatever thing, whatever at their own discretion, whatever necessity they have felt that we should mention this much scriptural knowledge, sorry, this much scientific knowledge in these scriptures, so they have mentioned. So as more and more research is being done, so more and more scientific knowledge of Vedas, actually so many scientists, they admire the Vedas. So that is coming out. So as far as science is making progress in material, in finding the material mechanism and other discoveries, so in the same way, as people are researching more on Vedas, so more scientific, hidden scientific knowledge of Vedas is also coming out.
Thank you, sir. It's like you gave like finishing answer. Now, no more question can arise in this. Yeah, it's a bit clear because as you said, yeah, because these scriptures are earlier, because everything was contest, then later they were written down. And yes, whatever was written down, they thought whatever was important, they wrote. And like small things, you may not find
yes,
the small,
yes,
small
yes,
things.
Yes, yes, yes.
But because the language in which they are written, it's a bit typical, because in order to understand,
yeah, yeah,
you have to go through process. Then only you will be able to get, you will be able to understand. So yeah, yes, many of the things are there. Like almost whatever I see, it's there, because I was also searching. I found that, yeah, Pythagoras theorem, it was there in Vedic scriptures, but we don't know actually.
Yes, yes,
so
yes.
So definitely we need to have thorough study, or you like, we can take some guidance from you to have such kind of study. How you manage like being engineer and also Vedic scripture readers? So yeah, it creates harmony between both the things, because what we read in science, it get proven by the Vedic scriptures. So it, yes, increases, yes, our enthusiasm. So thank you, Akash sir, for such wonderful explanation. So I would just request you to please give one conclusion, so we can wind up the talk.
Okay, so in the conclusion, I would like to say that this scientific knowledge and religious knowledge, they are not competitors, they are not contradictory, rather they are complementary. As I told you, that material mechanism and the intelligent creator, they both are complementary. Both things are needed to understand the thing perfectly. So we should harmonize the two knowledge, and we should take advantage of both the knowledges. Like through science, we should improve our understanding of modern phenomena and other laws of material nature, and through religious scriptures, we should try to develop our relationship with that creator who has created all these things. So thank you
very much, sir. I hope viewers, now it's clear to all that yeah, we have scientific knowledge in our Vedic scriptures. And yes, going to the question, that we have put to the sir, why is scientific knowledge like gravity is not present? Now we have to remove this knot. It's present in the Vedic scriptures. So thank you very much, sir, for explaining us very nicely and very easily with so many examples that made very much clear to all of our viewers. So thank you, sir, for giving your precious time to our show. We will be meeting soon, and I request you so that you may come again to our show. Thank you again, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
So, okay, viewers, we'll be meeting soon. Thank you for coming and joining us. Bye-bye.